Welcome to Adaxes. In this video, we'll be looking at Office 365 management and automation. Adaxes gives you the ability to manage Office 365 licenses, exchange online mailboxes, and on-premises Active Directory all from one place, eliminating the need to constantly bounce from one administrative console to another. And of course, with Adaxes, you can completely automate the process of assigning and revoking Office 365 licenses, and thus eliminate the need to do this manually each time a user account is created, updated, or terminated. Here's how it works. What you see on the screen is a series of onboarding procedures that I've configured for my environment. All these actions are performed automatically by Adaxes when a new user account is created in my on-premises AD. And one thing you may have noticed here is that one of the actions activates an Office 365 account for the new user. What I can do here is I can define how the user's location is set. In my case, this will match the country specified for the user in Active Directory. Or you can specify the country if you want to. And here I can also specify which Office 365 licenses to assign to users. And I can even select individual services within each license. All these licenses, by the way, were obtained from my Office 365 tenant, so you will see your own here. Furthermore, with the help of conditions, you can assign different licenses to different users based on things like job title, department, location, or in fact, any other criteria. For example, if I want managers to have an additional license in Office 365, I can add a condition to my business rule like, if the job title property of the user's account contains the word manager, and then I can add the modify Office 365 account action for this condition. And the action will assign the license that I want managers to have. As simple as that. Or if you use group-based licensing in Office 365, you can add a user to the corresponding group, like managers, and then the user will receive the licenses associated with this group. Another thing you can automate is mailbox configuration. Like this particular action assigns an address book policy to the user's mailbox in Office 365. Now, when we've got the business rule all set up, let's switch to Adaxes web interface to create a new user in the on-premises AD to see how it all works. To do that, first I need to fill in some details for the new user on this form, like first name and last name. Let's select a job title that contains the word manager. The default country is already pre-selected, so I can go ahead and click the Finish button. Adaxes will then create a user account in the on-premises Active Directory and execute all the actions defined in my business rule. So, now the new user account is created, if I navigate to the Office 365 section, I can see that Adaxes has created an account for the user in Office 365 and assigned the two licenses in accordance with the user's job title. Because this user has an Exchange Online license assigned, the Exchange Properties section is displayed here, and it tells me that a mailbox is being created in the cloud. And because I have a hybrid environment, Adaxes has also created a remote mailbox for this user in my local exchange, so I don't have to do anything myself. And here we go. A mailbox is created, and as you can see, the address book policy is assigned to it, exactly as configured in the business rule. Another benefit here is that the new user doesn't need to wait for AD Connect to do a sync, and can immediately use all the Office 365 services. Adaxes has also established a link between the on-premises and cloud identities, so AD Connect will synchronize the account information as usual. The automation capabilities of Adaxes are not limited to the onboarding process alone, meaning that you can also automatically update user licenses when something changes in AD. For example, when the job title property of a user account changes, Adaxes can automatically revoke all the licenses the user no longer needs and assign new ones as required in the new role. And as you may have noticed, in the web interface, I have all the data from both on-prem and cloud environments neatly presented in a single view. Here I have the on-prem account information, membership of AD groups along with Exchange Online mailbox properties, Office 365 details and licenses, all of which is fully customizable. If I switch to another web interface, here's one that I created for managers, you can see that the user interface is greatly simplified. And because I want managers to have the ability to assign Office 365 licenses to their subordinates, I've added the Office 365 section to this web interface. As you can see here, some licenses are not visible in this list, and I can be very granular with what is displayed here. For example, I can hide individual services that I don't want managers to deal with. And because they may not know the details of what each license is for, you can also assign more user-friendly display names to licenses and individual services. You can even take it a step further with delegation and give regular users the ability to manage their own licenses as part of the self-service process. This is Adaxes web interface for self-service, and I've added my own custom command here to let users request the Office 365 services they need. So, if I go ahead and select one of these options, as you can see, the license I need isn't assigned to me straight away. Instead, a request has been sent to my manager, and I will get the license only after the manager authorizes it. And finally, one of the most important things you have to do periodically is deprovisioning. A long series of time-consuming and complex offboarding procedures must be repeated every time a user leaves your organization. But with Adaxes, all those operations in the on-premises AD, Office 365, and Exchange Online can be performed in one go with the help of the deprovision custom command. As you can see here, after performing the sequence of actions in Active Directory, the command will deactivate the user's account in Office 365, which includes revoking all the licenses assigned to the user and blocking their access to your Office 365 tenant. But before doing that, it'll convert the user's mailbox into a shared mailbox. This makes sense if you want to have access to the mailbox after revoking licenses from the user. And also, the command will cancel any meetings organized by the user, hide the mailbox from address lists, grant the manager access to the mailbox, enable mail forwarding, and of course you can add other actions and customize the existing ones to fit your own needs. And now, if I want to deprovision a user account, all I need to do is execute the command. The rest of the job will be done by Adaxes. And when completed, as you can see, all Office 365 licenses have been revoked from the user. The sign-in to the tenant is blocked. The mailbox is still available, but hidden from address lists. The whole process involved just a few clicks and literally a few seconds. Adaxes supports multi-tenant environments, allowing you to manage multiple Office 365 tenants, each associated with its own AD domain, or with multiple domains across multiple forests, and you can manage all that in a single workflow. This way, Adaxes provides a uniform environment to work with data spread across Office 365, Exchange Online, and on-prem Active Directory, which simplifies all sorts of management procedures, making them more consistent and intuitive, which in turn gives you the ability to securely delegate them. And by automating the management of licenses in Office 365, you can make sure that all users have the exact licenses they need when they need them, for as long as they need them. Thanks for watching.